JFT, just fair and direct.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to JFT's daily market review for June the 30th. I am Charalambos Pissouros, senior market analyst here at JFT, and I will talk about yesterday's main market movers, what's my opinion moving ahead, what are today's important events, and how they could affect the markets. But before we start, let's read our disclaimer. The content we produce does not constitute investment advice or investment recommendation, should not be considered as such, and does not in any way constitute an invitation to acquire any financial instrument or product. I will leave you a few seconds to read the rest, and then we will jump into our analysis. The dollar traded mixed against the other G10 currencies on Monday and during the Asian morning Tuesday. It gained versus the yen, the pound, the Swiss franc and SEK in that order, while it underperformed versus the Aussie and NOK. The greenback was found virtually unchanged versus the euro, the Canadian dollar and the New Zealand dollar. The weakening of the safe havens yen and franc and the strengthening of the risk-linked Aussie suggest that market sentiment improved yesterday. Indeed, shifting attention to the equity world, we see that major EU and US indices were a sea of green, with a positive morale rolling into the Asian session today. Both Japan's Nikkei 225 and China's Shanghai Composite were up 1.27% and 0.66% respectively. This may have been due to improving data, enhancing hopes over a faster than previously thought economic recovery around the globe. Germany's inflation numbers came in better than expected, raising speculation that Eurozone prints due out today may also beat their estimates. However, with both the bloc's headline and core inflation rates well below the ECB's objective of below but close to 2%, we believe that the door for further easing by the ECB may stay wide open. In the US, pending home sales surged 44.3% in May, the biggest jump ever, suggesting that the housing market is staging a decent recovery. On top of that, Fed Chair Powell reiterated his view that more monetary stimulus may be necessary, adding to speculation that the US Central Bank will do whatever is necessary to support the world's largest economy. As for today, during the Asian session, China's PMIs for June came in better than expected, with both the manufacturing and services indices signaling expansion for the fourth consecutive month, despite the new flare-up in infections from the coronavirus. As we noted several times in the recent past, it seems that there is a battle among market participants between those who believe that the global economy will recover faster than previously anticipated and those who are afraid of another round of fast spreading of the coronavirus around the world. With infected cases hitting a new daily record on Friday, coming in just shy of the 200,000 mark, and with several US states reversing their reopenings, we prefer to stay sidelined for now. The neutral technical picture of global equity indices, as well as that of currency pairs, which act as major gauges of broader market sentiment, adds more credence to our view. We prefer to wait for clearer signals with regards to the market's forthcoming directional move. On one hand, further loosening of lockdown measures around most of the world may allow economies to continue their road to recovery, but on the other hand, the reintroduction of restrictions may result in a second hit to the global economy and thereby bring equity indices and risk-linked assets back under renewed selling pressure. Apart from the yen and the franc, the pound was also among yesterday's main losers, coming under selling interest on concerns on how the UK government will be able to pay for infrastructures after UK Prime Minister Boris Johnson pledged to increase spending. This, combined with doubts over whether the UK will find common ground with the EU with regards to their future relationship post-Brexit, may keep the pound under selling interest in our view. Remember that the latest round of negotiations resulted in no progress, and with the UK insisting that a solution should be found before December 31st, The default option remains a no-deal Brexit. Conditional upon further improvement in the broader market sentiment, we would prefer to exploit any further pound losses against currencies which tend to benefit from the increased risk appetite, like the Aussie and the Kiwi. Now, as for the rest of today's events, ahead of the EU Open, we already got the UK's final GDP for the first quarter, with the preliminary estimate being revised down to -2.2% quarter over quarter from -2%. The pound barely reacted to the release, perhaps because we already have data showing how the UK economy has been performing in the second quarter. The monthly GDP for April pointed to a 20.4 month over month contraction. Later in the day, apart from Eurozone's inflation data, we also have Canada's monthly GDP for April and the US Conference Board Consumer Confidence Index for June. Canada's GDP is forecast to have contracted 12% month over month after deteriorating 7.2% in March, while the US CB index is expected to have risen to 91.6 from 86.6. With regards to the energy market, the American Petroleum Institute weekly report on crude oil inventories is coming out, but as it is always the case, no forecast is available. Tonight, during the Asia morning Wednesday, we have Japan's Tankan survey for the second quarter and China's Kaijin manufacturing PMI for June. In Japan, both the large manufacturers and non-manufacturers indices are expected to have declined to -31 and -18 from -8 and +8 respectively, while China's Kaijin PMI is anticipated to have slid to 50.5 from 50.7. As for the speakers, we have seven on today's agenda: Fed Chair Jerome Powell, Fed Board Governor Lyle Brainard, Minneapolis Fed President Neil Kashkari, ECB Vice President Luis de Guindos, ECB Executive Board Member Isabel Schnabel, Bank of England Chief Economist Andy Haldane, and Bank of England Monetary Policy Committee Member John Cunliffe. So that's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and listening. For those who are interested in learning about the main events of the week much earlier, you can subscribe to the weekly Market Outlook webinar, which I'm holding every Monday at 7 o'clock a.m. GMT time. You can find the link in the description below. So goodbye, have a great day, and I'm looking forward to seeing you here again tomorrow.
JFT, just fair and direct.